friends, thanks for joining us for today's Kello Lane Living. I'm Brittany Kay.
And I'm Ashley Thompson. And I know I say every day it's going to be a great show, and it is, but keep watching because we're dancing in heels, learning to dance in heels today, and that's kind of amazing.
Yeah, we've been talking about this for a while, but I have to say I was not thrilled this morning to wake up because it was freezing outside. And I know that this week we've been warned it's going to, you know, start getting cold. We've been blessed earlier in January with actually some warmer temperatures. Yep. I mean, I love how we consider it warm temperatures when
we're
it's still not cold. But, yeah, even Jordy's leash, because it stays outside, and then I hook him up when he goes out just so in case he doesn't run away. And it was frozen shut, so I had to sit there and breathe on it with my warm breath.
You didn't do classic Brittany and get the blow dryer out.
I honestly probably would have if it wouldn't have unthawed.
Well, I have already said I'm going to go ahead and give you that one from now on. But
this is the perfect time to start talking about vacation.
Yes, that is a better way to warm up is to go on vacation. Where have you got? What's your favorite all-time vacation?
Well, I'd have to say my favorite all-time vacation is probably Jamaica. We went to Montego Bay and we climbed to Dunn's River Falls.
Okay.
And so basically it's a waterfall, and we took a catamaran there to do this, and then if you look to the right of this picture, that's us, and as you can tell, everyone else is on the other side of the waterfall, and that's because we told our guide that we wanted to go the fastest route so we could get back to the catamaran to start partying.
Not surprising at all, Brittany.
And it was so bad because it's super slippery, as you can imagine. This is just the beginning. The waterfall obviously is a lot bigger, and once you get behind these trees, my mom actually slipped on this part and fell into the waterfall and lost her bottoms. It was a catastrophe, but it was so much fun, and AAA is going to have some ideas
for
us today.
Your mom is the cutest. I wish I would have seen
that.
Yeah,
what was your favorite?
And I'm not surprised you went the fastest way back to the party. So I don't even know if it's my favorite, but I don't get to travel a lot right now.
Okay.
So a more recent fun trip was a girls trip I took to Malibu. It was for my friend Katie's bachelorette party. So there we are in Malibu. We're on the deck of Nobu, I'm pretty sure there. And a fun part about this trip was that Katie, one of my best friends since college, everybody else I'd never met before, so.
That's what's fun about bachelorette parties, though, because sometimes
really
you don't know anyone else.
And I'm still friends with all of these girls. We kept a group text going, and we text each other regularly. The group text is called Malibu Babes. We call ourselves
that.
It's fine. But it was super fun. So I can't wait to get more tips from AAA today about what kind of the hot spots are now and the good deals to get warmed up, because we got to go. I don't like this cold.
Exactly. And I know a lot of people probably think, well, I have kids.
Yeah,
traveling
that's
is
my
hard.
Problem.
But actually, I came across this article that was talking about why it's good to travel with your kids. And so some of the points that they had were, A, that it really introduces them to a larger world, which is very important. But then some people argue, well, my kids are so young, they're not going to remember this. But they have a bigger argument that goes over that case. And it's basically, you know, makes them more adaptable and flexible because you're getting them out of their routine. Unplugging and bonding, very important. You create memories, obviously.
Yes.
More adapt to say yes to new experiences. So if you put your kids in those situations, then they're going to start doing that the rest of their life. And then trips are not always smooth sailing.
Oh, 100%.
And life is not always smooth sailing.
Gotta learn it young.
Set your kids up for that.
Even if they can't remember everything, the things that they learn up front continue to shape them, really. And those, they become their own kinds of memories. Yeah. I travel with my kids. It's good for them. Is it fun for me? Not necessarily all the time. So I took my kids to Chicago this summer. Most of our trips are with my husband for work. So we were at an architecture convention. And this is how the trip kept going. We're at the river there. Fox, he would not have a picture.
He looks so excited.
So then the great mom traveler I am with my kids, the next stop after this was top of the Hancock for a martini.
You are brave for bringing your kids
up. Yes, so I brought all my kids up to the top of the Hancock to the Signature Lounge, best views in Chicago, and I took a little bit of the stress off with a martini.
I love that.
Everybody around me was like, good job. They loved it. It was great.